Hi, my name is Tom, and welcome to On a Student Budget. Today we're going to be doing a review on the Sennheiser Momentum on-ear headphones. I recently done a review on the over-ear Bigger Brothers in this annotation right above my finger here. And I've also done two comparison videos, one which is talking about just like the quick comparison, which is a little bit of everything, in this annotation right above here. And I've also done a specific sound quality comparison between the two headphones right above here. So definitely check those two links out. But in this review, we're going to be talking about the accessories that come with the headphones and the features of the headphones, and also the build quality, the design, the comfort, the weight, the isolation, the sound quality, of course, and also whether or not these are good for portable use. But without further ado, let's get on with it. In terms of design, I think these are just a smaller version of the Momentum over-ear headphones, which is not a bad thing at all because those are very good looking cans. These are, I would say, flashier looking because they come in a wide variety of different colors. They come in the black, as you can see here, glossy black, come in green, red, blue, pink, and ivory as well. So you'll definitely find a color that suits your taste. And this is a more of a retro looking headphone. On the head, it looks very nice. I'd say it looks amazing, actually. The entire, like what is this, the headband? The headband is a stainless steel band, so it's very, very durable. And the cables are made very well, so I have no complaints on build quality. In terms of comfort, I think Sennheiser has done a fantastic job with these guys. By definition, on-ear headphones are not the most comfortable headphones because how small the ear pads are, they're pressing against your ear, so that's not the most comfortable feeling. And if they don't press hard against your ear enough, they also break seal, and so you lose sound quality as well, and you lose they're not secure. And what Sennheiser has done was basically the clamping force on these headphones is a little high, but the ear pads are so soft and so well padded that it basically mitigates the actual clamping force. They use a material called Alcantara, which is a synthetic suede-like material on the ear pads and also on the headband. I think it's very well executed. It's very breathable, it's very comfortable, there's no irritation at all. For the headband here, it has a split headband, so the gap here allows for more air ventilation, so it prevents any hot spots or anything like that. And it also, because of the headband's a little wider than normal, it's very stable on the head. In terms of the ear pads, it's very well padded as well. I would say it's on par right with the Vmoda XS in terms of comfort, and that's very good place to be. And they are actually think that they're very secure as well, because even though they're so comfortable, they don't feel like you're pushing against your head. Like, they don't move. They don't move at all. And also, these headphones weigh about 160 grams, which is very, very lightweight. And because they're so lightweight, they actually don't need much headband padding. And I think this is a fantastic, they've done a fantastic job designing this headphone just on comfort alone. In terms of isolation, this is one area I think that the Momentums actually suffer from. Even in your, I would say it would work well in libraries, walking around in neighborhoods and stuff, but I don't think they're enough for like commuting on trains and even buses or anything like that. In terms of overall sound quality, I think what Sennheiser has done is to cater more towards the broader consumer market, get a more lively, more exciting sound signature. Starting from the base, normally portable on-ear headphones, because of how small their enclosure is, they're not able to reach as low, and they're not able to like produce more bass and high quality bass. And I don't know how Sennheiser has done it, but they found a headphone to, like, the bass on these guys is emphasized in the sub bass in general, and I would say that they found a way to make it extend very low. The bass is very well extended, it's very well emphasized. I would say the bass is almost approaching bass head status. I would say this is a little much for me, but there's a little bit of a looseness to the bass, but so it makes it more boomy sounding, so this helps it for rap and hip-hop music for sure. But I wouldn't say that it's muddy at all. The mid-range does not get clouded because it's a very clear mid-range. I would say that vocalists take a couple steps back from the bass and the treble, which makes it a little unnatural sounding. Not that that's bad. This is better for more electronic rap hip hop music, kind of like that. Going into the treble, I love the treble on these guys because it's just so exciting. It's fun listening to these guys. The terms of soundstage is something another feature that Portal On Here headphones really don't excel in. It's so wide. It sounds like a very big room that you're listening to, and it's taking this on the go. This is fantastic. I would say in comparison to the Vimota XS, which is another very popular headphone, on-ear headphone, I think these are direct competitors to. The Vimota XS has a more punchier bass. They both have that similar looseness in the bass. This is better. This has more rumbling sub bass, so better for action movies. In terms of mid-range, I do prefer the Vimota XS because it has a forward mid-range, so male and female vocals do stand up more, and they're more natural sounding than these guys. They're both just as clear, I would say, as each other. Unfortunately, I don't own the Vimota XS anymore. And going to the treble, I would say I prefer the treble on these guys more because it's more extended, it's more exciting, it's more lively, it's more crisp. The Vimota XS is more of a laid-back treble. It's not as extended as these guys, I would say, and also I find these are to be more articulate. But those Vimota XS is like better for those that listen to more on Spotify and more stream music on YouTube or those kind of musics. Soundstage, I prefer these much more. It's just my preference because these are wider sounding than the Vimota XS. The Vimota XS feels like a smaller room, and it's a more intimate sound signature. But I do think that these are slightly more diffuse sounding than the Vimota XS. But overall, in terms of sound quality, it really does depend on if you want more bass and vocals. That's the Vimota XS is better for you for that. If you want more of a V-shape, a more exciting, lively sound, I would say that these guys will do you great. In conclusion, I think the Sennheiser Momentums are a fantastic portable headphone. I would say that if you're using these for subway use, as I said in the isolation section, or bus rides, it's not the best for that. It's not the best for like sealing out the outside world. But if you need a headphone that sounds good when out and about, and you need to also be aware of your surroundings, and for it to look good as well, I think these are a fantastic choice. As I said before, they come in a wide variety of different colors. You'll definitely find one for your liking, and or maybe two, actually. I think that they're a fantastic choice, and I think you should really take the time to demo these guys, because I think they're well worth it.